morning and welcome to St. Mary. Today is the optional memorial of St. Henry. Today's mass is being offered for Donald Spahn at the request of Anne Marie Wilson. In your strength, O Lord, the just one rejoices. How greatly your salvation makes him glad. You have granted him his soul's desire.
Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. In my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, whose abundant grace prepared St. Henry to be raised by you in a wonderful way from the cares of earthly rule to heavenly realms, grant, we pray, that through his intercession, amid the uncertainties of this world, we may hasten towards you with minds made pure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you with the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord, princes of Sodom. Listen to the instruction of our God, people of Gomorrah. What care I for the number of your sacrifices, says the Lord? I have had enough of whole burnt rams and fat of fatlings. In the blood of calves, lambs, and goats, I find no pleasure. When you come in to visit me, who asks these things of you? Trample my courts no more. Bring no more worthless offerings. Your incense is loathsome to me. New moon and Sabbath, calling of assemblies, octaves with wickedness, these I cannot bear. Your new moons and festivals I detest. They weigh me down. I tire of the load. When you spread out your hands, I close my eyes to you. Though you pray no more, I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves clean. Put away your misdeeds before my eyes. Cease doing evil. Learn to do good. Make justice your aim. Redress the wronged. Hear the orphan's plea and defend the widow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you?
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Alleluia. 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 apostles. Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and one's enemies will be those of his household. Whoever loves his father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is righteous will receive a righteous man's reward because he is righteous. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because he is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward. When Jesus finished giving these commands to his 12 disciples, he went away from that place to teach and to preach in their towns. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Here at where we understand completely that the gospel texts are not like Hallmark cards. They're very powerful, and it's a true commitment and a service and a surrender to God. Religion is not just these nicety sayings with the sky and the sun and the birds chirping. Christianity is all about the cross. And it demands for you and for me to adhere to the cross and to understand it. Now, don't get me wrong, we should not be going around like a sorrowful mystery every day, that we're droopy and sad and everything is wrong and look at woe is me, I'm a follower of Jesus. No. We adhere to the cross because we understand its glory. We adhere to the cross because we understand who he is in relationship to me and to this world. And it's not compromise. My faith, my decision to follow Christ is that of sincerity and complete trust and surrender. And that comes with gospel joy. That comes in an understanding that everything that God has given to you and to me and to this world is a sheer gift. It's a gift that is to be given to us in gratitude to him who has immense love for you and for me. And we come upon the gospel text such as this, where Jesus says, "Do not think that I've come to bring peace upon the world. I have come not to bring peace, but the sword, and to set a man against his father, and a daughter against her mother." Well, what is all that about? I thought Christianity was not that. I thought it was birds chirping and sunsets and all these beautiful Hallmark sayings. What is it then? What is Christ calling me to? He's calling us to a deeper awareness of ourselves in relationship to him and our commitment to him, our decision to follow him. And all of that will not necessarily always bring about peace. It will bring about division. It will set us apart from people. We will lose friends. And even our own family members may not adhere to this and understand it, because they don't want to enter into the following of Christ when it demands the cross. No one likes the cross. Even our Savior asks his Father, "If this chalice can pass from me,
Let it be done. But not my will, your will be done in me. Which is absolutely the center and the crux of Christianity. Doing the will of the Father. Through the person of Jesus Christ. In the power of the Spirit. Oh, it is a great decision to follow Christ as his disciples today. In a world that opposes the cross, in a world that opposes gospel values, in a world that does not want to adhere to what Christ is calling all humanity, in following him, leading them to eternal glory. They want to do it their way. They have a Frank Sinatra theology, so to speak. I've done it my way. Well, for us, it must always be, I want to do it Christ's way. And that is so beautiful about the life of St. Henry. Did you ever read about his life that we celebrate today at this memorial? He wanted to be a priest, and things did not really go that way, so to speak. And I say he studied early a lot of theology before even the seminary. And he served God in a particular different way. He served by an earthly rule. And it's so interesting, it would be against what many would say about political spheres today. Henry was very much dedicated to God. Very, very dedicated to God. And all his actions and deliberations were always in union with that faith that he professed. Imagine that. To follow your faith. To allow your faith to guide your life, no matter what you do in life. Whether you work in sanitation, whether you're a teacher, whether you're a mom or dad, whether you're a politician, no matter what you do, this is constant for me. I'm a follower of Christ. And that's not going to sway what I do. Henry brought a lot of people back by just the way he spoke and the way that he governed. How beautiful that is. May we look to St. Henry today as a great inspiration, especially in this time of civil unrest. There are many men and women in this world who have come before us, who are now here, and will come after us, that really have a great calling to bring about good in this world, even in the civil platform, and to allow others to be called by that. I guess Henry understood this gospel, that it's not always going to be peaceful, but you do the right thing. You don't give in because, well, maybe they're not going to like me, or maybe they're going to disagree with me, and I don't want to start any friction. I don't want to disturb anybody, so I'm going to shut my mouth and just be quiet. The serious sin is that of silence. But the one who speaks, even though it may cause a little bit of disturbance, it's something that you speak with truth and clarity. And it's done with the whole notion of the gospel message. It's done with respect. Our conversations and our deliberate discussions. We can't love anyone more than we love God. We love God first, and then we love other people that God has brought into our life. I know you love your husband, I know you love your wife, and I know you love your children, and I know that you love your grandchildren, and you should love all those people. You absolutely should love them. But you you first love God first, because without God, you wouldn't have him. You would never have found your wife, your husband, your children would never have been born from you, and your grandchildren. It's all a gift. And that's why it has to be done in the proper order. And once we love in the proper order and we understand what that love is all about, then we truly have a relationship with God that is right order. And we understand that in following him, and that cost of discipleship will cause many people an unrest or uncomfortability. Even children, adult children, who don't adhere to Christianity or Catholicism anymore, who don't understand the respect for all human life from the first moment of conception until natural death, who don't understand that marriage is between a man and a woman. And it goes on and on and on. And so there's a little bit of unrest, there's a little bit of uneasiness, there's people that in your family that don't talk to you anymore. There's children that disagree with you and argue with you. Jesus speaks about this to his apostles. And then did you notice after this dissertation, when Jesus had given these commands and he had finished giving them, he went away from that place to teach and preach in their towns. So he went to their towns where they were from, just to allow this to really take root and to understand. I love my mom and dad, I love my sister and my brother, I love my nieces and my nephews, but they know without a question of a doubt that God comes first. And there's always been that way, that God comes first. And sometimes I will not be seeing them on Christmas and Thanksgiving because of another commitment. But I still love them and still pray for them. Doesn't mean I stop loving them. And they also know where I stand on all these issues. And I'm not going to waver and sway. But I say them because it also puts a seed into their mind and allows them to think a little bit about all those issues that are based upon gospel values and not the world's values. I've decided to give up world values. I don't adhere to all that. These are my values right here. And each day, I base my faith and my trust on God in these values. So St. Henry, today the church celebrates this political ruler, this person of a man of great faith that did not compromise one bit. I guess you both can be a politician and a Catholic at the same time, go figure. And if you don't believe that, let's read the life of St. Henry and many others, like Thomas More. May God, who begun the good work in us, bring it to completion. After reflecting God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For Pope Francis, may God the Father grant him the wisdom of the Spirit and the heart of the Son to unify the Church. Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve in positions of civil authority, may God's peace reign through them in place of the sword and division. Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from unjust treatment, may the Lord encourage them and deliver them from their trials. Saliga, Felicia and Rita Lockery, Kate Long, Aiden Malone, and all those on our prayer list. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Donald Small, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like St. Henry did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also pray for an increase in vocations to priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise of the Lord and his name, for our good and the law of his holy church.
As we give our offering at this sacred altar, O Lord, on the feast day of your saints, we ask your mercy that this oblation may render you supreme glory, to win for us an abundance of your grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as in the festival of St. Henry, you bid your church rejoice. So do you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so in the company of the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, be holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Be holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant,
which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who art thou saved and glorified by numerous miracles, the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who devoutly implore her protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven, who with the Father and Holy Spirit live and reign God forever and ever. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, who for the accomplishment of your greatest works have chosen the weak things of the world, that your flesh may glory in your sight, and who for a better and more wide infused in the Immaculate Conception
recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the sacrifice